Match game 74, production number 0246, and it's take one.
Get ready to match the stars. Maury Amsterdam. Red Summer. George Kirby. Joanne Clute. Richard Dawson. And Betty White. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 74. And now, here's the host of Match Game 74, Gene Rayburn.
How you say, Pat?
Hello, Jerry Olson. Thank you, thanks for joining us here.
Don't do it if it hurts, Richard. How are you? How's everybody?
Terrific.
Sure,
nice to see you
again.
Like this once in a while.
Not too
Listen,
well,
everyone,
Gene.
You're not too well?
No,
Betty.
Just being well. No,
I'm
just
sorry.
It's all right.
Are you not well?
No, I'm all right. I just
Is there
feel
something
a
we
blue.
Can do for you?
No, I just feel a little blue.
Yeah. Listen, shall we raise your spirits?
No, don't you touch me.
Does that make you feel better?
Yes.
Good. How do you feel, George? Hey, listen, we ought to welcome the new kid on the block, George Kirby.
Hey! Isn't he a melody in pink?
He's a melody in pink. If you don't have color television, you really ought to see that.
Looks like a poor movie.
Looks like an ad for a bowl of borscht.
I can hardly wait for tomorrow. Did you bring a lot of those, George?
Oh, yes.
Good. All right.
He robbed a float in the parade. How are you?
Good. What, my tie's crooked?
Yes,
okay, Mom.
Ooh. I fixed that
oh,
before we
go
went on the air.
Tied.
She used to work for a funeral director. She does it very well.
Doesn't he look natural?
All right. I'll do the whole show like this so my tie won't get crooked, Dick. All right, here we go. Let's say hello to our two celebrity, whoever you are, Kendra Plummer and Jack Holder. How are you, Kendra?
Fine.
What is that?
That's a meatless fish.
She's got a meatless fish on her lapel, she says. Kendra's a current champ. She's won $5,600. Just one game, she went all the way and did a perfect thing there. And she's very happy about that, aren't you?
Ecstatic.
Really? What plans do you have for that money, Kendra?
Well, I hope to give us a better start when we get back east.
Okay. And Jack Holder is challenging her. He has had his first round question and did pretty well with it. Captured half of the celebrities with three matches. And we're in the middle of round one, and we've got a first round question for you, Kendra, coming up right after you have a look at these messages. Here we go. I'll push his button, and nothing happens. Oh, there it is. Don't push a button, and something happens. All right, Kendra, this is your question. Everybody plays. Here's a little riddle for you. What's big and green and covered with fuzz? The answer? The Jolly Green Blank. Big and green and covered with fuzz. The answer is the Jolly Green Blank. Now you think about that, Kendra, while they're writing their answers here.
Big
and green and covered with fuzz. It's the Jolly Green...
That's the silliest thing.
It is silly.
I know it.
Upper tier is ready. The first time this has ever been
ready. Come on, Richard!
Don't drink your beer.
Well, we expect it from Joanne Flew. She hasn't learned how to write yet.
Now, Kendra, the little real, what's big and green and covered with fuzz? The answer, the Jolly Green...
All I can think of is buzz.
The Jolly Green buzz...
It's the only thing that rhymes.
The money went to her head, folks. The money went to her head is what happened. Okay, the Jolly Green buzz is what she says. Let's see if anybody
else...
Well,
that's what she said, but I said the Jolly Green idiot.
Yeah. Buzz, okay. Brett?
What is a buzz?
I don't know.
The Jolly Green buzz. I know what a buzz on is, but I don't know what a buzz is.
I guess she had a rhyme idea there.
Yeah.
Well, this may sound like it's not true, but it's a dead truth.
It is.
Because you know, I was raised in the country, and I come from Maine.
Yeah.
Hickory nuts, but when you take them off a tree, they have a little green thing around them, and they're all fuzzy.
Right.
Well, that's all right for you to say, but it happens to be accurate information.
It is. I am happy to agree. Learn a little little something every day here on Match Game 74, folks. There, George.
I don't know what farm you come up from, but the farm I come up from, it would be
a green peach.
Green peach.
A big
a
green peach.
A peach is as smooth as a baby's blank. When
no, 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 no. No, no. Now, the peaches I know are all fuzzy. Listen, stop this now, right now. That's enough of that. Show us your answer.
I have a very obvious answer, because something that's covered with green has to be in the water. So I put... A moss rock.
Moss rock.
I tried to put covered, you know, a moss-covered
rock. Moss-covered rock.
But I thought it would be too many words.
The jolly green moss rock.
The jolly green moss rock.
Oh, I like the sign of
that. Yes, it's great.
I like it.
You've been away
Excuse
a long time,
me.
Haven't you?
I have to get thinking like
right.
this. Okay. Very weird.
Richard, what say you?
I thought George's answer was very good.
Big and green and covered with fuzz?
Yeah, so it was very... You know how to make a peach cordial?
No.
Blow it in her ear. I said peach.
You said peach, yeah. too. All right. No buzzes over here, Betty.
Jolly Green Fuzz, at first I thought was a good-natured Irish policeman, but it isn't.
It is.
It's a peach.
It's a peach. That seems to be the answer. Okay. Now we go to round two here and ask Jack to make a selection.
B. Right.
He wants B.
Match.
Well, in the first round,
you weren't
this
here.
Position
Thanks.
Was matched. That position was matched, and so was that.
I
so the
see.
Three of you will not participate.
They were sitting way back like this.
Right. Because of the energy shortage...
Uh-huh.
Instead of taking Scarface to the electric chair, they made him blank on the freeway. No, you can't. You really regret not playing this game, though.
I do, boy.
I guess George and Maury are ready.
Yep.
Okay.
No.
We're all set here for Jack Holder. Because of the energy shortage, instead of taking Scarface to the electric chair, they made him blank on the freeway.
Drive. I just came
Drive.
Down it.
What'd you say?
Drive. I just came down it.
Oh, you just came down the freeway. It was pretty risky, was it?
Right.
They made him drive on the freeway, he says.
That's
Maury, what do
I
you say?
Said.
Well, according to statistics, a man is knocked down by a car every 10 minutes.
Yeah.
I figure this guy must be made of iron.
By now, that's right.
No, I said they made him walk blindfolded on the freeway.
Walk blindfolded on the freeway. Does not match drive, George?
Well, I said lay down on the freeway.
Lay down on the freeway. That'll do it every time. You did? Lay down and drive. Betty, what do you say?
I said drive like a streak on the freeway.
Streak. Okay. So, Jack, you stay at three, and you've got a question coming up in a moment or so, but right now we've got a message for you, and this is it. That's right. All right, we're all set to go here and finish this game. Kendra, three matches to tie, four to win. And listen carefully now. This is a question about Dumb Dora. Dumb Dora was so dumb...
How dumb was she?
She was so dumb, the first time she was on an ocean liner, she thought the porthole was a blank. That's how dumb Dumb Dora was. You asked, and I told you.
Dumb Dora was so dumb.
When she got into a cab, they left a vacant sign up.
She was on an ocean liner. She thought the porthole was a blank. Oh, there are a couple of beautiful answers to this. I can think of two great ones.
Don't you?
Two? Don't
you? Daddy, you know we haven't had you here for a long time. We've missed you, but would you just thank you?
All right. We're all set now. And we'll ask Kendra. Dumb Dora was so dumb, the first time she was on an ocean liner, she thought the porthole was a...
Picture.
A picture. You're getting groans from the audience, Kendra. They're groaning you two times in a row there.
Oh.
That could be bad. I don't know. We'll find out. A picture. That hadn't occurred to me. Maury, what'd you say?
I'm very happy it hadn't occurred to you. But fortunately, it hadn't occurred to me either.
What occurred to you?
I figured because it happened to me. I thought it was a washing machine.
Yeah, that is a good answer. You know those washing machines with the glass in it, with the clothes tumbling around? Don't you think that's a good answer? What do you say there, lady?
I never have washed
with the fake
clothes.
Hair on your head? You never washed clothes.
I have washed only by hand. I have an old scrubber. I just out there in my backyard and throw them in my pool. I think Hendra's gone bonkers.
Yes, she has. The money went to her head.
I said John's seat looks just like a John's seat.
Sure, that hadn't occurred to me either, George.
I got news for you. When I went overseas in the Army, I'll never forget, I got caught up on deck, and I thought it was a John.
You thought it was a John.
All right, Kendra, you've got to match your three remaining celebrities to stay in the game, and let's see what happens here. We'll begin with you, madam.
Well, I'm as zonkers as Kendra did, because the only thing I could think of was something that was round, and I said a donut.
A donut.
All right, so Jack Holder wins the game. What do you got, Richard and Betty? Charity. Okay. Congratulations. $100 for you, sir. Now, we've got to say goodbye to this lady, but she's not going to be very sad as she goes, because she goes with $5,600. Thank you, Kendra Plummer.
Thank you.
And she's gone. You can stop waving now, folks. But thank you.
I don't have my glasses on. Has she left yet?
No, she has.
I thought the studio was leaving the building.
All right. Now, here we've got Jack Holder up here. His first go at the Big Money Supermatch. You ready?
I hope so.
I hope so, too. Okay. Jack, we polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Blank stack. Oh. The answer they gave most often is worth $500 if you match it. If you match the next one, it's $250. The third, $100.
Oh,
which celebrities would you like to get a little assist from?
Richard Dawson.
Richard Dawson, what do you say?
Smokestack.
Smokestack is what he says.
Do you like? Betty?
Betty?
Haystack.
Haystack. All right, we've got two, Jack.
And Maury.
Smokestack.
It's already been said, hasn't it?
Another smokestack. Have you seen those chimneys with two smokestacks? Hat rack.
You can't think of another one. Okay.
Stack.
So,
Bob Stack.
You've got two stacks there, smokestack and haystack. You can choose one of those as the answer, as we call for one now, or think of one of your own, Jack. What do you want to do?
Smokestack.
You want to choose smokestack and hope that's under the $500 response. Huh? All right. We'll find out if it's up there right now, and if so, where. First, may we see the $100 response?
Oh, it is, right off the bat.
Well, congratulations, Jack. I'm curious to see. A haystack's got to be up there someplace, doesn't it? You think it's the next one? And Robert Stack, that ought to be there. What do you think is under the next one?
Oh, Robert Stack!
Well, let's see the 250, shall we? Robert Stack is there. He was hiding under the haystack, which is probably under the $500 response, wouldn't you say?
Yeah.
There it is. Okay. That was Betty White's answer, and it was a good one. You've got the 100. Now you play for 10 times that amount, or $1,000. To collect, you've got to match one celebrity, and it's time to choose one now.
I'll take it with Betty.
All right. He's got confidence in you at last. You see, you proved you were a winner there, and now you'll face me, Jack, and Betty will write a response to this. Blank rabbit. Blank rabbit. Blank rabbit. Finished. Okay. Now, what answer would you come up with, Jack, in order to match Betty White in filling in that blank? Blank rabbit.
Jack rabbit.
Jack rabbit. You've got the audiences with you. If Betty White is with you, you've got it made. Let's find out for $1,000 right now, Betty.
I forgot your name was Jack.
Jack Rabbit! Congratulations, Jack. Who's that screaming out there? Where is she?
Right there.
Oh, yeah. The redhead is screaming her head off there. Is she pregnant?
Yes.
How pregnant is she, Jack?
I'm afraid to say right now.
All right. Listen, it's only money. Don't let it excite you too much. She's very happy about that, and we're happy for you, too. And we're going to carry on here right at this point, Jack. But first, we've got a message for you, and this is it. All right, we're ready here to carry on and start a brand new game. To do that, we're very pleased to present a new player. Let's welcome Rose Carter.
All right, Rose. You know, Jack?
We will now hear the Rose Carter story.
Okay.
Rose it's Carter? Short.
Is it short?
Yes.
Why?
Tell
us.
Because I am.
Oh.
I live in Glendora. I'm a housewife, and I have
two little boys, Patrick and Gregory.
All right. You're happy about that, are you?
Very.
We're happy about that, too. Good luck to you, Rose. Shall we begin?
Yes.
All right. I'll push a button and ask you to make a selection.
B, please.
B. Brand new game. Here we go. Little Red Riding Hood said to the policeman, I'm looking for my grandmother. She's a sweet little old lady with great big eyes and a great big mouth, and she looks a lot like blank.
Did I miss something?
No. It's Little Red Riding Hood said to the policeman, I'm looking for my grandmother. She's a sweet little lady with great big eyes and a great big mouth, and she looks a lot like blank. Yeah, they're very slow
they
up there.
Off.
Not me. I'm so fast, you're scaring me.
Okay. Everybody ready up there?
I'm okay. Ready. You stutter, too.
Now let's see what Rose Carter has to say about this. Little old lady with great big eyes and a great big mouth, and she looks a lot like...
Oh, Martha Ray.
You rehearsed your groaning, eh? Did you? That's the best groaning audience we've ever had, isn't it? Martha Ray is your answer, eh? Let's hear one more groan for Rose Carter there. Okay. I think they're trying to tell you something, Rose. Maury, Martha Ray's your answer. What's yours?
I think I came up with just as good a one.
Really?
Yes. A hungry camel.
I'm a little low for Maury there. Okay. Brett?
One thing to say, I was not the only person who did not understand that question.
Obviously.
I said, look like a wolf. Oh, thank you.
See?
But they're applauding the hissing.
No, they're applauding you. That's the answer. George.
Well, I could just picture her standing there saying, she looks like this in the big eyes, and she looks just like me.
Like me? Little familial resemblance there. What do you say, Joanne?
Well, he was on the right line, except it was the wrong object of a preposition. I said, like you.
Like you.
Me and you ain't a preposition, honey. It's a pronoun.
It's object of.
Object of.
Oh, shut up.
It's a female Richard. Sheep.
Would you read the question again, please?
The question is, I'm looking for my grandmother. She's a sweet little old lady with great big eyes and a great big mouth, and she looks a lot like...
Brett.
He's afraid of me, I know.
So am I.
I could have taken her, but I haven't been well.
I know.
He had another woman with her.
That's 19 professional fights, you know. Don't fiddle around with him. Do you fiddle around with him?
No,
you don't fiddle around
with him. She doesn't even fiddle around with Alan Waddy.
Oh, dear. Now... I'm sorry to say, Betty White, after all of that huzzah, you've got to show us your answer.
I bet you had Martha Ray.
Martha Ray was the answer.
I did not have Martha Ray.
That Rose
I did
Carter
not.
Came up with.
And she looks a lot like Lassie.
Like Lassie.
That's nothing. That's a real okay. Dog
back
answer.
To Brett again.
Yeah, there we go. All right. Now, that's for Rose, and now this is for Jack. Here we go.
Oh, okay.
Tarzan didn't have a flag.
What?
So... I said Tarzan didn't have a flag.
Well, I never said he did.
What kind of argument is that?
So let's get on with it.
Oh, all right. That's what I thought. I thought he wore it.
So when he marched in the jungle parade, he waved a star-spangled blank. It's all right. It's nice.
That's why he walked around going, oh!
All right. The top row's ready and the bottom row's ready. Just put it right in the slot there and let's get on. Okay. Jack Holder. Tarzan didn't have a flag, so when he marched in the jungle parade, he waved a star-spangled...
Banana.
Banana. Star-spangled banana. Star-spangled banana. I don't know. There's something euphorious about that answer.
Yeah, I got better than mine.
What's
I
yours?
I said loincloth.
Loincloth. Yeah. What do you say?
Well, I actually think there is only one answer, isn't there? I don't think it's banana, dear.
What is
a
that?
Loincloth.
Loincloth. George?
I've been to the jungle, and I know he waves a loincloth.
He does wave a loincloth.
Well, I don't know how he marched. He streaked in the parade, I guess. What do you say, Joanne?
He wasn't streaking because even though he did wave this, oh, I got myself all in a fuddle.
Yeah,
what anyway, it's the
what have you got there?
Loincloth.
Loincloth. That's four loincloths so far. What do you say, Richard?
Well, Joanne said it so eloquently. Loincloth.
And Betty White.
Well, I'm very sorry I don't match Jack, but I'm very happy I don't match the rest of these folk. A leaf.
A leaf.
Star-spangled leaf.
A leaf. Okay. So at the end of round one, we have no score at all. I don't want to say we got a couple of dummies up here, but... the first round questions are really very difficult, and you'll see how good they are in the second round, but first we've got to do a little bit of this.
Listen, I'm sorry to say we've got to stop right here. I got so carried away, I thought we'd churn right on to round two, but we've got to hold it up here, and we'll finish this game next time we get together. I want to say you were all splendid through this whole miserable mess.
Well, thank you.
And if you've got the guts, you'll show up next time. This is Gene Rayburn for Match Game 74. Join us next time. Goodbye.
This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 74. A Mark Goodson, Bill Chapman production.